grab your fam and grab some clay, because it's time for family art making. What's up, Ringling fam? It's Kallie, and we're finally on week 3 of our journey to the Center for Asian Art. This week, we'll be looking at sculptures, and not that old boring stuff. This sculpture is really new, in art terms anyway. We have a lot of cool sculptures currently on display in our Chow Gallery, but I'm going to tell you about just one that I think is really special. This sculpture was made by artist Fujikasa Satoko, and it's called Soaring Through the Heavens. She is an incredible sculptor for many reasons, but I especially want to focus on the technique she uses to make these sculptures. Nowadays, a lot of sculpture and pottery is done on a pottery wheel. You put the clay on the wheel, it spins, you add water, and you mold it to the shape you want. But Satoko uses a process called coiling. You might have rolled out little clay snakes before while you were making art. Well, she does exactly the same thing. Here's a video of her doing this technique. Each one takes a few months to create. First, she sketches out her design and makes a small version as an example. Then she begins making her coils out of clay and melds them together. Because of this technique, it can take a long time, as you can imagine. She only made 10 of these sculptures in 4 years. Another reason these take a really long time is that she makes these sculptures really thin. The walls of this one and other Satoko sculptures are extraordinarily thin, varying from about 2 centimeters, about the size of 2 sugar cubes placed side by side, to 3 millimeters, about the size of 2 pennies stacked. With such thin walls and using this coiling technique, there's always a chance that something is going to fall apart. It could break during the making, drying, and even the firing, and that just makes this process take even longer. For this sculpture, Soaring Through the Heavens, that we have, and others in her series, she was inspired by nature. Her sculptures might remind you of the motion of the wind blowing or birds flying, but in an abstract way. It doesn't look like wind. What does wind even look like? But it shows what the feeling of wind might look like. She hopes that her forms may remind you of the same sense of happiness and excitement that she herself experiences from nature. Now that we've learned a little bit about Soaring Through the Heavens and about that coiling technique, we're gonna try our own version, a little bit simpler, because I'm no Fujikasa Satoko, okay? For this project, all you need is some clay. I would recommend using Model Magic because it air dries and it's really easy to work with. If you'd like to make a sketch of your work before you make it, just like she does, you'll also need a pencil and a piece of paper. So I did start mine off with a sketch, and because I liked Satoko's idea of being inspired by nature, and also because the Model Magic that I'm using is blue, I decided I wanted to make something inspired by water. And just like she did the movement of the wind and the feeling of wind, I decided to go for trying to recreate the movement of water. So it might not look exactly like it, but I kind of liked the idea of, you know, when you drop something heavy in like a pond and it splashes up, that's kind of the idea that I wanted to use. So kind of like a splash. So, to do this coiling technique that I've been talking about, you want to pinch off a little piece, and I find it easiest to start by rolling it in a ball, and then you want to roll it out with both of your hands into a long, snake-like, worm-like piece. And then you can chop that up into smaller pieces if you want. You'll see that I do that throughout the video. To start off with the bottom, to make the base, I coiled it around in like a spiral, and then just kind of melded the coil pieces together so you couldn't tell that it was one big spiral. You still kind of can see the different pieces. You can mold yours together more than I did, and if you're using actual clay, you can use a little bit of water to help get rid of those lines and creases, but I didn't mind that much if it had lines. If you want, I definitely encourage you to scroll back a little bit and watch Satoko connect her coils together, because I'm doing a very simplified version of what she did, but hers is a little bit easier to see. So you'll see, you'll keep making those little snake-like coils, putting them one on top of the other, stacking them if you want to do it like Satoko did, and then mushing them into one another. And then if you keep mushing them and you want to make yours really thin like hers were, you can keep mushing and mushing. But as you can see, some of mine were so thin they started to fall apart and I was having to make things up as I go, but that's okay. That's what the professional artist does. And that's what Miss Kallie does too. So if yours starts falling apart, don't worry about it. Just roll that clay back out and start again. So I decided to make kind of a middle piece and then a bunch of little splashes to the side once I realized that that big thing in the middle that I wanted to go straight up just was not gonna pan out. It's almost like making tiny bowls or pinch pots and then stacking them together, connecting them. So you'll notice that I just keep playing with it, messing around with it, molding it until it looks kind of like I want it to. And here is my finished splash sculpture, as I'm calling it. I really like the way that it looks from the side. I think it does kind of remind you of a bunch of little splashes, maybe. It doesn't look exactly like my sketch, but I still like it anyway. I hope you had fun learning the coiling technique and making your own sculpture. If you did, I would love to see what you made, so you can send us a picture at the Ringling Facebook page, the Family Programs Facebook page, or send us an email at education@ringling.org. And if you do, let us know that it's okay to share it with the rest of the Ringling fam. So I will see you next week for our last video in June, but we will be back in July. Don't worry, stay tuned to find out what the theme for July is. But I will see you next time at the same time and in the same place. Bye! If you're making art along with us for fam this month, save your artwork. We are doing another family art exhibition in our community gallery this fall, and we will start looking for submissions in July. Everything that you make fits perfectly with our theme, which we'll announce soon.